wish, there is death. Been teaching classes, executing recipes with mastery, precise blows in front of the public. How many times don't we see them receive applause for their precise hand, for their precision, for their movements that are finely trained by practice? Now, I would like to extend you an invitation. Imagine a great cooking class, a chef with his shining white uniform in front of an audience that is avid to acquire knowledge. A chicken enters the stage. The chef, in a tender gesture, takes this animal, puts it on his lap, and pats its head. In 1 second, his expression changes. With energy, he twists the chicken's neck. It breaks. The animal, still agonizing, has its neck cut, and the blood is put into a bowl. This shocking scene may turn the chef into a savage in the audience's eye, a tyrant. I'm a fisherman. I'm a hunter. I've always dreamt of making a video of newly caught fish being cleaned, cooked, and eaten. A cycle with beginning, middle, and end. The idea is to talk about the many faces of the chef that I am. A primitive man, a fisherman, a provider, a transformer, a glutton, and a gourmet. The idea of this still unmade video has always sounded lyrical, romantic. But if in the place of a fish I used a chicken or a duck, I would run the risk of being labeled as cruel, bloody, ruthless. When we go to the fishmongers, our eyes travel over colorful fish, small and large, over lobsters, crustaceans, shells, all of which make up a diversity, a colorfulness that instigate us to cook, to eat. On the other hand, when we see the photo of a recently killed wild animal, or if we imagine a butcher shop full of dead ones, such as calves, cows, goats, lamb, rabbits, or pigs, the reaction is adverse. All this seems vile, sinister, gloomy. Why? The rational answer I can find is that fish, when they die, do not change their expression. They keep looking alive. Their shine and their freshness make them look clean in our eyes. Something that does not happen with the rest of the animals. Their expression of apathy, their expression of agony, or their very lack of expression may be the root of this. What I would like to say here is that killing chicken, ducks, pigs was a part of our recent ancestors' experiences, our grandfathers' and grandmothers' experience. And we remember with affection and romance the taste of food that they made. Because of the needs of urban life, man has distanced himself from the first and primary activities needed to execute a recipe. He's lost touch with the termination of a life that many